Yes, you make no plans for that, so you can have no idea. That's what's supposed to do all of this. But the Holy Ghost, amen, can lead and guide you in all of the things and all of the ways of God. How many glad to be here?
Amen.
Without further delay, we're going to present our speaker tonight. Great man of God. I really love this man. Amen. I'm glad I met him. I don't know. That was just God hooked us up together about 20 years ago when he used to come and do all of these events at the YMCA. He would give his testimony. And he was good with it. Boy, he could really tell you what God had done for him. And he just inspired all of us. And we just felt led at one of those occasions to invite him to come and minister at this church. This is how we actually met Brother Scales and got him to come, amen, starting him coming to Northside Christian Center. How many believe that was a good move of God? How many believe that God was with us? Amen. Hallelujah. So without further delay tonight, we're going to bring our speaker tonight, Evangelist Robert Scales, Pastor Robert Scales, all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. Let's receive him, man of God, as he comes and minister the word of God.
Y'all lift your hands up, give Jesus praise. Yeah. Hallelujah. Let's magnify him with the fruit of our lips. Yeah. Amen. God want to hear something out of our mouth. Amen. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Bless his holy name forever. Amen. But why don't y'all shake hands with two or three people, tell them you love them, you're glad they're here, and you can be seated. Amen. I'm just so blessed and honored to be back in Northside. Pastor Hill, Sister Marilyn, and all the saints here and all y'all coming visiting tonight. Amen. It's a blessing to be here. I got a word from the Lord. He talks to me and leads and directs me. And so I just stay humble and always live in a way that keeps my dependency on him. Where that I'm not living in my strength. The Lord's taught me so much since I've been pastoring. He taught me how to walk in victory after I first got saved. But he's really taught me so many things I never would have got to preach and learn had I not been a pastor. Because I've learned, he's taught me to teach how he's taught me to live in victory. And a lot of things that I live are just revelation, me just being yielded to the Holy Spirit. But as I've been pastoring, he's taught me how to explain it, how to teach it, how to reveal it to others that they can walk in that victory too. And so turn your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. And I'm going to teach you all again tonight on of just holding fast to the confession of faith without wavering, because the Lord is faithful and promised. And I think sometimes we hear, you know, all his promises are yes and amen, but I don't think people understand what his promises are. His promises are the words that came from Jesus' lips. Every time you go through anything in life, you need faith, and Jesus is faith. And so what you have to get faith from is what he say.
Amen.
There's no other way to get faith. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the words that came from Jesus' lips, the Messiah, Romans 10, 17. The Amplified Bible. And so a lot of times, you know, you hear people talking about what's wrong, what they're going through, but they really should be hearing what comes from Jesus' lips, or seeking Jesus, from believing in him that he's the one sent from God with no sin, and that he took our sins away. I believe this is some of the most hidden truths that people really don't know who Jesus is, and they think they do. But he's the one sent from God with no sin. When you believe Jesus is the one sent from God with no sin, you really believe it. He knows everything. And you can't lay all your dependency on somebody unless you know you don't know and they know.
Amen.
And so it's a lot of us or people in the way. And the reason why their faith don't work right, because they're trying in their strength to accomplish things when that they really should be looking unto the Lord. One of the things I did when I first got saved, June 30th, 1988, was I knew I couldn't live right. And I see people try. And so when I was 2 or 3 years old, I'd been coming here. I'd go back home and go back to my church, my pastor. And I began to ask the Lord, Lord, why do people, you know that they got saved around about the time I did. Why do they struggle so much? Why, do you love me more special than people? And because I didn't know why. And Jesus spoke to me and told me exactly. He said, I don't find many people who will let me do what I want in their life. And he said, when I get a chance to do what I want in your life, he said, then all your cares and problems, I work out. He said, I'm not getting the work days out. But he wants to. He wants to be Lord in our life. Amen. And for 23 and a half years, I just haven't lived a depressed day. And so, you know, that can mess with people's minds, you know, that, oh, no, you ain't Jesus. No, but I believe in it. And so really, many times, people don't understand what really believing in Jesus really means. But real Bible faith is hearing who Jesus is, believing in your heart, saying it with your mouth, and then acting on what Jesus tell you to do. People done made faith be something else. And a lot of times, it's a lot of dead faith in the body of Christ that don't have no action with it. One lady said, and I'm just quoting her, she said that her friend just died. She said she knew how to reach God. She knew how to reach. She didn't no more know how to reach God. She wouldn't have been living the way she was living if she'd have reached God. When you reach God, you get power and strength and holiness and godliness. You don't reach God and stay the same.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You can't reach my Heavenly Father through Jesus and stay the same. That stuff is religion. It's dead faith. Why? Because it doesn't have no action of Jesus showing up being who he say he is, the one with no sin. Think everybody say that out. Jesus is the one with no sin.
Jesus is the one with no sin.
Well, what do you think he wants to produce in your life? Come on now.
No sin.
No sin. And he can do it.
Amen.
If he'll find somebody that'll let him. Somebody just crazy enough to say, Lord, I can't, you can. Show me how. Bam.
Glory to God.
So he teaches us here in Hebrews 10:23. Listen to this now. You'll get blessed tonight. Let us hold fast the confession of faith. Now, here's what I told y'all last night. They added in here our. Look in your Bible. You'll see ours italicized. That means it ain't in the original Greek. So what this verse, it's going to hurt you to believe he's talking about your faith here. He's not talking about your faith. He's talking about Jesus' faith. Hold fast the confession of faith. Jesus is your faith. Faith is who Jesus is and what Jesus did. and you tapping into that, causing that faith of how he lived perfect, overcame the world, defeated all the works of the devil, he is our wisdom, he was made our righteousness, he was made our sanctification, he was made unto us our redemption. So you are going to live a life where you are in faith in Jesus. Your faith in Jesus is getting in your mouth what he's saying. And then doing what he tell you to do. Faith is saying it. Who Jesus is and what Jesus did. He's the one sent from God. Tell any problem. Tell any circumstance who Jesus is and what Jesus did. That circumstance be to start shrinking right there in your face. Why? Because he overcame the world. He defeated all the works of the devil. What could you bring him? What could face Jesus that could make him tremble and make him not have victory? Nothing. Because he's already overcame the world. So let us hold fast the confession of Jesus. Because he's the only one ever lived perfect. We should be talking about Jesus all the time. People don't. They talk about what's going on. And we're to do it without wavering, without doubting, without questions. Why? For he is faithful, that promise. And in the Amplified, it said he is faithful to his own word. And so when you begin to trust Jesus, you are trusting who he is. The one sent from God with no sin. And what he did, he took your sins away on that cross. He took every one of them away. You got this. That's our faith. That's our faith. That we've been forgiven of everything. And so when that becomes, this is what I begin to tell people. That this was the thing that thrilled me when I got saved, was that I felt clean inside. And that he loved me. And so I begin to walk in that. And so Jesus, a lot of Christians don't understand this. They don't understand faith. But here's faith. When I first got saved, and they kicked me out of drug treatment center, because the man wrote on the board, Jesus cannot get you off drugs. And so I just had a bright light came in my room. I was delivered, and what do you want, Scales? Last night I had a vision. Jesus came in my room and delivered me. I'll never use drugs no more. Jesus set me free last night. He turned red, got mad, broke the chalk, went down there and said I was disrupting. He said I want him terminated now. And they came and brought my termination papers, and he went and came in there. And while they were getting the papers ready, and he said, now y'all look at him. He said, I'm going to prove to every one of you he'll go back and use. And so I went back 7 years.
Go ahead.
And said, well, I'm still free. And then the Lord told me to stop because I was in pride. You know, I was sassy with it. You know, and that's not the spirit of the Lord. And so after that night, I went to church, and they were smoking cigars, and it's terrible to have churches like that you can smoke on the, terrible to smoke, but they smoke on the church ground, and have cigarette in the bathroom. It's a disgrace. And so I had some cigarettes left, and because I couldn't smoke there, I hadn't smoked in 2 weeks, and then I wanted a cigarette. I wanted one while I was in church. So I got out, I lit a cigarette. I asked the deacon for a light, because I ain't had no light. And then he gave me a light. And as soon as I remember seeing the fire on the front of it. As soon as I hit it, Jesus said, no, you can't smoke no more. You got to give them to me too. See, I gave lust for women, gambling, stealing, drugs, alcohol. But I still had cigarettes. Now, Pastor Kels, how did you still have the cigarette? Because I smoked. Anything you go back and do, you still got it.
All right.
See y'all. I say, anything you go back and do, you still got that. Fear, worry, stress, anything you go back and do, you still got it. And so, so a lot of people don't realize this, don't understand this, that I didn't see it when I smoked that cigarette. And a lot of people don't understand the scriptures. But I never did say, Jesus never asked me to repent. Because I hadn't done nothing wrong. And so, man, after he told me that if I'd ever smoke sin, and when I know to do good, now it's sin to me. And so when you walk by faith, it's not you doing anything right. It's once he tell you, then faith has to trust him, you don't do that no more. In his power and in his strength. And so I never spoke sins. Then on the way home, now watch, I'm living by faith. Why? When the designer, for 30 days, I got calls to smoke every day. When I got through eating, oh God, my elbows wanted a cigarette. My toes and everything just would be jumping. And so here's my faith with action. I told people Jesus set me free from smoking. I was in the NA meeting at McDonald's, and the guy in front of me had a pack of cigarettes. They fell out of his back pocket. One jumped out, rolled on the front of my toe. And it did. And the devil said, put that behind your ear. He'll never know. You know, come back in the day, he would have got that cigarette back. If I had a whole pack, I'd have kept that one. You see, because I thought that was free. And so I picked the cigarette up and picked his pack up and gave it back to him, and I told the cigarette, and then I looked at it, I had it in my hand. I couldn't put it behind my ear. And I said, I told her, I said, Jesus set me free from you. I said, you can't even make me put you in my mouth no more. Yes. Jesus got greater power than you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Go ahead. Now watch that, See, my faith ain't in me. My faith was in how great he was. My faith was in his power was greater of keeping me from smoking than the cigarette and the devil telling me I had to smoke again. I was believing something with action. My faith had action. Then here we go. I'm on the way home. I done got filled with the Holy Ghost. Speaking in tongues. Burning. The fire of God was on me. Jesus said, this girl over here talking, taking me home. And Jesus spoke to me. And I turned around and looked on the back seat. Because I said, there was somebody on the back seat talking to me. So you can't live with your girlfriend no more. You're married to me now. No, don't teach that. Don't teach that. Watch that. Listen for a minute. You got to listen. See, I want to teach you faith, and I don't want to teach you about you being nothing. I want to teach you faith in Jesus. It don't have nothing to do with you being careful. It don't have nothing to do with doing your best, hanging in there, hold on. None of that's faith in Jesus. When anytime you got anything to do with it, it ain't faith in Jesus. When he got anything to do with it, that's when it's faith in Jesus. When you got anything to do with it, it ain't never faith in Jesus. Y'all be real careful. See, it's not faith in Jesus. You don't have to be careful when you put faith in Jesus. You need to be careful to keep trusting him. And so I the Lord told me, I asked her, I said, did you hear that? She said, what? I said, forget it. Watch. That was faith for Jesus to tell me I couldn't live with her no more. Y'all got to get it. That was faith. I believed. I went to the house, told my girlfriend that I was married to Jesus and I couldn't live with her no more. And I packed my clothes and left that night. That's action with my faith. Until you do what Jesus says, your faith is dead. Listen, well, I know the Lord came. That's dead. If that's by itself. Well, I know Jesus can help me. I know the Lord can provide. No, that's dead now if he don't come through. And what people have done, they help me, Derek. They call stuff faith that ain't faith. And it's dead faith if you don't see the Lord come through. I've just never, in since June 30th of 1988, I just refused for the Lord not to come through for me. I'll pray fast all day and I'll stay on him and find out what I did wrong, what I'm doing wrong. I never have put up with no prayer. My prayer's not getting answered. That's why I ain't had a depressed day. I haven't been late on bills. Never been behind on nothing. Never paid interest on credit cards. And that's not bragging on me. That's bragging on him coming through. That's faith. You ought to want to hear people that have lived by faith. I mean, you have a whole story on in Hebrews 11. You ain't mad at none of them because they live bad, are you? Paul said, the Lord has delivered me and will. He delivered me out of every evil and will deliver me. You ain't mad at him? So why can't somebody tap into that today? That is just strange to people that somebody talk like this. And it shouldn't be. All of us ought to be living by faith, living by Jesus, what Jesus saying. We believe in that and speaking it in our mouths. When Jesus told me, he said, now I've set you free. I just went and told everybody Jesus set me free. Then, what is that right there when I tell people Jesus set me free? That's my faith. That's my faith in him. That he said he set me free. That's my faith. Now what's my action? Is when the temptation comes, I tell it Jesus set me free.
Amen.
And I resist it. That's my action with my faith. That's my action with my faith. It's living the way Jesus told me to live. He said, I've set you free. I have to have action with that. Are you following me? He is not going to give you the action. Abraham, he didn't give Abraham the action. He gave Abraham the word. He gave Abraham the faith. It was up to Abraham to believe and to go do what God told him to do. God don't do your action. He do your faith. He didn't take Isaac up in the mountain. Abraham took him up there. Are y'all listening? Jesus did not leave my girlfriend's house. I left it. Jesus did not tell the cigarette, you can't rule me no more. I told it. Are y'all listening? And if you don't get action with your faith, man, your faith is dead talking about Jesus and he don't come through.
Amen.
And people done got used to this.
Preach.
They done got used to this. Hold fast to the confession of faith without wavering. For Jesus is faithful that promise. Let me go to Hebrews 10:35. Look right here. Cast not away therefore your confidence. You know what your confidence is? Come on now. What is your confidence? Hush back here. What is your confidence? Come on, y'all got to know this. Is what he said. Don't ever let nothing cast away what he said. You finna be messed up. Anytime you see people struggling, they have cast away what Jesus said. If Jesus said something, you ain't struggling. If you will hear what he said, believe what he said, speak what he said, and then act on what he said. You gotta do what he tells you. Or your faith is dead. Well, I believe in Jesus, but I'll tell you, I've just been worried all day. Well, I know I smoke and drink, but I'm still saved. Hold on, man. What kind of saved are you? Saved from what? What are you saved from? Well, I got the Lord in it. He lives in me. Well, why don't you get him out? Quit locking him up. If he's in there, why he ain't helping you? Huh? Or why ain't you at least trusting him to that he's on the way? You don't see it all at once, but you ought to be full of joy and full of peace that the victory is coming.
Amen.
The money's coming.
Yes.
That one thing about peace and joy, they don't come. Peace and joy don't ever come.
Once you tap into faith, peace and joy there. You ain't never waited on peace and joy. That you ain't. But Jesus said, come to me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I'll give you rest. You roll that care over on him, that you got peace instantly. He give you joy instantly. You ain't never been in church. When that presence hits you, peace came instantly. You ain't saying, oh, he touched me, but I'm still waiting on the peace. Mm-hmm. When he touched you, that peace was down. Yeah. Joy was down. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Cast not away your confidence. Mm-hmm. What Jesus said. Why? It has great recompense or reward. Everything Jesus said got some reward in it. You ain't winning, you ain't got nothing he said. You struggling financially, you don't have nothing he said. Jesus told me, Pastor Hill, I'm telling you, back in 1993, Jesus told me one day, said, I've made you a rich man. I had a dime in my pocket. I couldn't even make it clean. You know, you need a couple of them just to make some money. I just wiggle it around in my pocket dry. Just wiggle it. I couldn't, you know, because I was trying to feel good that I had some kind of, I had 1/10 cent. And I couldn't even make it say nothing. You know, we was on the street, we would just, you know, cling it together just to have a little noise. And I couldn't even do that. But out of my mouth, I said, Lord, I believe that I'm a rich man. I start saying that the Lord done made me a rich man. And from 1995, I ain't been broke since. I ain't ran out of money since 1995. Dr. Leroy Thompson came to the church and the Lord gave him a word about never being broke no more, you understand? And I love him and couldn't go all the way with everything, but that word was from the Lord. God don't want his children broke no more. He said, how many of y'all don't never want to be broke no more? Man, I threw my hands. I wanted to raise up both feet. I couldn't get both of them up at the same time. But I was trying to raise up both of them. My hips raised up. I said, Lord, do I have anything else I can raise up? Because I'm telling y'all, I'm broke is a curse. I'm telling you, man. You know, I'd rather go on to heaven than be down here broke. It's bad. And the Lord, he spoke. And so then I watched people in church, they just still broke, still struggling. But I went home and said that thousands of times. Every time I wrote a check, I'd never be broke none damn like much money coming to me. I've never been broke since. I went home saying that thousands of times. Why? Well, I really believed it. See, your faith is your mouth. See, your faith is who Jesus is and what Jesus said, and you saying it. Then you do what he tell you. Saints, I'm telling y'all, this is the way this thing works. This is how you get free from any bondage. You get healed of any disease. You get delivered from anything. You can call your children in that ain't even living right. If you'll learn to say the same thing that Jesus said. Amen. I prayed for my brother years ago and the Lord would send laborers across his path and he would come to know Jesus. 2 years went by. And he still drank and still smokes his cigars. And I went and told the Lord, I said, Lord, now I asked you this 2 years ago to send labels across my brother's path and bring the knowledge of your love to him. I prayed that to you. And you didn't answer that prayer. He's still drinking and smoking cigars. And so the Lord didn't say nothing to me and I left it alone. I'm smart enough to walk in the light I have and the stuff I don't understand. I don't just walk in. I leave it on the bookshelf or back in a corner somewhere. I never live in what I don't understand. You can't live in what you don't. People just love to hang around. I don't understand. No, I need to live in what I understand. You can't walk in what you don't understand. You got to leave what you don't understand on a shelf till understanding come to that. And so I told the Lord, then we was at Thanksgiving over my grandmama's. And I said, Pen? I said, why you gonna go to, I said, ain't nobody ever come and talk to you about the Lord? I said, nobody. I said, ain't anybody came and talked to you about the Lord? That's what he said. He said, oh yeah, there's a preacher right up from my shop. He owns a shop. He said, that man been coming up there for 2 years talking to me. Woo, hallelujah. Oh, God is a good God. And see, I got this from Jesus.
Yes.
I got this from Jesus. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence. I won't cast away what he said. I won't cast away what he's done for me. I keep it in my mouth, which has great recompense of reward. Look at that. Look at that. And for you have need of patience. See, a lot of people don't know they have need of this. But that word patience. Listen to things. In the Greek, one Greek translation I studied was the best one I ever heard. It's not to succumb under any kind of stress, any kind of temptation, not to succumb to whatever's telling you against Jesus. You have need of staying the same and saying the same thing that Jesus said. You always have need of that after you've done the will of God. What's the will of God? The will of God is you believe on him who God has sent, and then you believe on his love and authority, and then you live that love and authority toward one another and against the devil. That's the will of God. That's the will of God. A lot of people don't even know what the will. They think the will of God. Something. The will of God is you believing and doing what Jesus tell you to do. That's the will of God. It's nothing else. Now out of that, then you know God. I'll show you all kind of stuff. After you've done the will of God, believed how he loved you, and live that love toward others, you will receive what he said. It's been 4 or 5 times that I didn't get my prayers answered. And this was the first 5 years I was saved. I ain't had no more of them. And them was connected to forgiveness toward my wife. And he said, I told her I forgave her. But then when she would say something down on this side, I said, So I didn't say that out of my mouth. It's down on him. See, he see them spiritual sins that nobody else can see. And so when the money didn't come, I said, Lord, now I prayed and this didn't happen. He said, yeah, you've been mad at your wife. You didn't forgive her like I forgave you. You ever notice I never remember nothing that when you repent, I never remember. And I just bless you like you ain't never done nothing. He said, you ain't doing her like that. He said, you got a little ick. A little ill that can't nobody in church see because you smile all the time.
That's good.
And so you can trick man, but you can't trick God. And I said, Lord, yeah, I'm so sorry. You forgive me. I said, Lord, I love her now. I took my screwdriver out, made me a little adjustment, and turned from that. Got right back in the blessing, seen my prayers get answered, seen the Lord come through. And it's just sad that we don't see the Lord come through, and then we think we in faith. And we don't see the Lord come through, and we think we in faith. Well, I don't. I see him come through. Amen. Because I know that I'm messing up something that he's told me to do, and all I got to do is get that straight, and then I'll see him come through all the time. Jesus can't fail. Jesus can't fail. Now, this is what lives inside of you. Mr. Can't fail. Can't mess up. You know, y'all read about Jesus turning water to wine. You know why he turned water to wine? Huh? Do y'all know why Jesus turned water to wine? No, that ain't why. Somebody heard what he said and done it. That's why I'm dead free. I heard what he said and done it. He turned water to wine because he told these men to go fill up these pots and go pour it. And when they done that, that's the reason wine came from water. Because they did what he said. Your blessings are going to come when you believe who he is and do what he say. And you can do this every day. Listen, I done been in a spot where I had no hope of doing nothing he said. I just was strengthless. Amen. And my faith had just withered. I'll just be honest with you. I understand Peter. You know, Jesus say, do this. Lord, if it be you, bid me to come on the water. If it's you, but they were scared, thought he was a spirit. So he said, all right, I'll prove it's me. Come! Because Peter knew that if Jesus said, see, he knew if this was a spirit, that he couldn't tell him to come too. He knew only Jesus could tell him to come. He knew if Jesus said it, come on now, he could do it. And so Jesus said, come.
Peter stepped out of the boat, started walking on the water, come to Jesus.
And the winds blew. And Peter began to sink. But he had enough faith to say, Lord, help me. And I done been in them spot years ago. I don't do it now because my faith done grow. But I used to say, Lord, help me because I'm a sinking. And you know what he did? And then he had to teach me how to not be fearful. And you know what he asked Peter? You know what Jesus asked Peter? Why were you fearful? Do you know the answer? Because he didn't say what Jesus said to that wind. He didn't say what Jesus said. All they do is say, Jesus told me to come out here. Stop it, wind. We will stop. When the devil and anything on this earth hear what Jesus said, it has to stop. Everything obey Jesus. Everything obey the Creator. But it's got to hear what Jesus said. In my name. Remember them, the man had devils and his son and threw him into fine waters and all of a sudden now he took went to the disciples and said, man, y'all can't eat devils out of my child. A young man did. And they went over there and couldn't do it. And then they called Jesus. And before Jesus cast the devil out of the young man, he said, why are y'all so faithless? How long I got to suffer y'all? Oh, he would have that on a recording. That would be a gold record platinum if he was on earth today. And Jesus said, bring him here. The father, he said, how long you been with that little child? He said, Lord, if you can do anything, help us. If I can. And then Jesus turned around and said, if thou shalt believe. Now watch, now y'all don't even know what to believe is. If you'll believe that I came from God, that I know everything, all things become possible if you will believe who I am and what I say. Everything become possible in your life. And here's one sin, y'all, that Jesus didn't die for. They say he died for all our sins, but no. It really ain't true. He took all our sins away, but there's one sin he didn't take away. And this is the truth. It's in the Bible. It's the sin of unbelief. You have to believe. You can't get forgiveness for that. You have to believe. It's no how in the world he going to forgive you of unbelief and you still in unbelief. You have to believe. So the man said, Lord, I believe. Help me not to go back in unbelief. See? Because he had unbelief, but he was believing now. He gave Jesus all he had to believe that Jesus could do it. And Jesus cast that devil out of him. And people just, they're not seeing Jesus right. They put knives and guns and machetes and all kinds of stuff on me. Spirit of the Lord, can I just point at them, tell them. God sent me over here, overseas, Grenada, West Indies, St. Croix. They had a witch. They said it was put in Kingston and St. Croix. I was preaching over there, and this lady was a real witch, had a pot. She put spells on people, man, many people died. And so I